Michael Barrymore now out with a broken list. That means a reserve comes into play. And I don't know if Gemma Collins is on that reserve list. But Michael, have you had any indication, any behind the scenes of seeing him in action, how he was doing?
I feel absolutely gutted. I was there last week filming the Dancing on Ice special. He is so funny. And obviously, this was his big comeback. And I just feel it's a real shame.
What was he like on the ice? What did he look like?
Well, we weren't that good, I'm going to be honest. He was OK. But do you know what? It's just maybe not meant to be for him this time. And I'm happy to stand in. But they have got a stand-in, so let's hope nothing happens to that stand-in.
Do you know who the stand-in is?
I don't actually, no.
I'm hearing unconfirmed in my ear.
I've not met them. But it's just such a shame because he was really, really looking forward to his, you know, coming back to the TV. And he had everyone in stitches, as you can imagine. And it's just a shame, really.
Well, that leaves us now with magician Bren Hanlon, Maura Higgins from Love Island, Perry Kiley from Diversity Dance Group, Caprice, the model and businesswoman, Trisha Goddard, talk show host.
Christmas special is this Sunday, 7 yes. p.m. So is this like a launch show as well? So we see all those contestants with their partners, and then what are you doing?
Right, well, the contestants this year have definitely got it a little bit easier because they get to get out the first night nerves. We've pre-recorded the live show. They've had a little taster of what's to come. The standard is a lot higher this year than it was last year. And I burst onto the ice as well with them. Mm-hmm. And do my little bit.
Literally burst on.
I burst on. I burst on. Well, basically, there's one point where I have to jump out of a box. When we pre-recorded the show, I jumped out so early that I nearly gave Phil and Holly a heart attack, basically. So sorry about that, Phil and Holly.
But can we just say, you jumped out early because somebody cued you out early.
It was nice to say this time it wasn't my mess up or my fault.
And that person was one Dan Harris, who we know very well.
Yes.
Oh, not him.
We passed him on.
Well, he was a producer here.
Dan Harris, honestly, honey, you're taking the rap for this one. It wasn't me this time.
Were you nervous going back on the ice? Have you skated since then?
Yes. I wasn't nervous at all. I was buzzing to get back on that ice. Who'd have thought? And it was quite a big moment for me because, obviously, the trauma that my knee suffered, the swelling's just gone down.
Really? All the time.
On my right knee, I've still got swelling on the left, but I was just like a duck to water. I missed the ice. It was great to be back on.
But when you've had a huge fall, as you did...
Trauma.
Does that not set in your mind?
Oh, like, I had trauma.
This could happen.
It was tough at the time, but I'm a true believer in after doing the show, you've got to fight your fears and do them anyway. So, for me, getting back on the ice this time, I just had to face it and go with it, and I didn't fall over in rehearsal, and you don't see me fall on the main show, so... Yeah, it was good news all round.
Would you ever like to sit on that panel of judges?
Do you think you'd be good on that? Do you know what? Everyone wants me to do the Love Island. I mean, I was trending on Twitter yesterday and I was like, hang on a minute, I'm trending. What for? There's so many people wanting me to do that. Would I be a Dancing on Ice judge panel?
Because you'd know how they'd feel. You'd know how they were all feeling, wouldn't you?
Yeah, definitely. If I got the call, why not, you know? But you know what it's like in TV. They put them people... You know, you have to wait your turn.
And what about your series, your Diva series?
Diva's back. I've had another two. Yes, two commissioned for next year.
So where are you going to be for your next Diva session?
Well, basically, I haven't made any decisions yet with regards to where we're going to be filming it, but I am dead excited and I do want to be obviously heavily involved this time in what we're doing. So you never know. I could end up in Kilimanjaro. You just don't know, do you, with the GC?
Christmas, obviously, any minute now, only a week.
Yes.
So do you love it? Where are you
going to be? Christmassy this year, though. I'm going to the Dorchester this afternoon. I'm taking all my staff out for Christmas. We're going to have a fun time today.
What time's that happening?
3:15. You're more than welcome to come.
I've got to be on the radio at 4.
That wouldn't be there for long. We can give you a little Christmas scone.
Yeah, that's lovely.
But, Christmas with the family and, you know, it's been a great year. So, time to celebrate and eat lots of Brussels.
Will you give Arj our fondest? Because he's one of my favourite people.
Yes, yes, absolutely. 1,000,000%.
Good, good. Well, happy Christmas.
Thank you.
And we will look forward to seeing you dancing on ice
at
Christmas this Sunday at 7 p.m. on ITV. Lovely to see you.
Thank you.
Have you been a good girl? I'm just asking on behalf of Santa.
No, terrible. No. Always am.
Always am. Always am. But always make a smile and always lovely to see you, Gemma.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed.